Welcome to this ASP.NET Core Charts Control tutorial. The Syncfusion ASP.NET Core Charts Control is designed to visualize data in a graphical format and is highly customizable. You can use it to create a wide range of charts, including line, area, bar, column, pie, donut, and more. In this video, I'll show you how easy it is to add the charts control to an ASP.NET Core web application and populate data points. I'll also show you how to configure a chart with a title, legends, data labels, and tooltips. Let's start with the ASP.NET Core web application creation. Make sure you have installed one of the following versions of the .NET SDK on your machine. Now I'll use .NET 8.0 framework. You also need to install one of the IDEs. In this video, I'll use Visual Studio 2022. First, I open Visual Studio 2022 and choose Create a New Project from the dashboard. I select the ASP.NET Core Web Application from the template. Next, I'll provide details like name and location. I'll create the project with the .NET 8.0 framework. The project has been created and is ready to use. Now I will show you the step-by-step process for adding Syncfusion ASP.NET Core Charts. I open the NuGet Package Manager, search for the Syncfusion EJ2 ASP.NET Core package, and install it in my application. After the package is installed, you can find it under the Packages section. I open the View Imports Razor file and import the Syncfusion EJ2 tag helper. Next, to add the script reference, I navigate to the Layout CSHTML page. Add the script reference for the Syncfusion ASP.NET Core controls. And register the script manager using EJS scripts tag at the end of the body section. I need to register the Syncfusion license to avoid the license validation message. So I open the program CS file and register the license key using the register license method. To see where to generate a trial license key, check the description below. To add a chart control, I navigate to the index CSHTML page, add the EJS chart tag, and set the ID attribute. Let me run this application by pressing the F5 key. The chart component is rendered with two axes, X and Y. However, no data is plotted on the chart. Now let me show you how to visualize the sales data in the chart for a particular year. To show data points in a chart, I need to bind data and connect those data points using a series. In this application, I am going to use line series. The next step is to add the series collection tag, which allows you to specify multiple series. For now, I define a single series using any series tag and set the series type to line. Next, let me demonstrate how to populate a chart with data points. I can bind JSON or remote data to the chart using the dataSource property. I navigate to the controller page, create a model class layout data, and define the fields like period, online percentage, and retail percentage. In the index page, I define a list variable, sales data, and add a few data points based on the layout data model class. I'll assign this list to the dataSource property of the series tag. After binding data, I need to set the XY axis to the series. I assign the period field to the X axis using the xName property, and the online percentage field to the Y axis using the yName property. Since the x-axis in the list contains categorized data, I need to configure the horizontal axis with category using the primary x-axis property. So I include the eChart primary x-axis tag and set the value type property to category. Look at the chart now. The data is plotted with line series and a categorized x-axis. You can also plot multiple series in the chart. To demonstrate that, I have added two Y series to represent the sales percentages for both online and retail channels. Here I will add another line series for the period and retail percentage fields. Now the chart has two line series. You can also provide a piece of information about the data plotted in the chart by adding a title. Let's see how to give a title to the chart as well as to its X and Y axes. To provide a title to the chart, I add the title property and set its value to sales data. I set the title to the X-axis by including the title property in the eChart primary X-axis tag and set its value to period. To set the title to the y-axis, I include the eChart primary y-axis tag and set the title as sales percentage. Notice here, titles are added to the chart and its x and y-axes. Next, I will show you how to set a legend on the chart. A legend provides information about the series rendered in the chart. I add the eChart legend settings tag and enable the visible option. Then I specify the first series name as online and the second retail. See here, the chart is rendered with the legend. You can also collapse and expand the chart series by clicking the legend. To improve the chart's readability, I plan to add markers and data labels. Markers are used to show details about the series data points. In the first series, I add the eSeries marker tag and set the visible property to true to show a marker on each point. Also, add an eSeries data label tag and set the visible property to true. As you can see, the chart displays data points with markers on the first line series. To avoid cluttering the chart with data labels, you can use tooltips to display data values. The tooltip provides a convenient way to view the data without taking up too much space on a chart. I include the eChart tooltip settings tag and set the enable property to true. Check now. Tooltips are shown when I hover over the data points in the chart line series. Now let me quickly summarize. I have shown you how to create an ASP.NET Core web application and add a chart control with a few basic properties. You can download a working example from the GitHub link shared in the description below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will get you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.